Thank you. Good evening, Nadia Aquina. Thank you for coming. The invocation for verses to share, stories to share, in God's blessing. God is first. Isaiah 6:8. Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?" And I said, "Here I am, send me." Short verse, something to remember in your heart. In Isaiah 46:3-10, the Lord says, "You I have carried since you were born." This year, my oldest, and this is a short story. This year, my oldest child graduated from high school, and I am not ready to let her go, despite reminding myself that this is a natural and necessary part of life. I have been struggling to hide my bittersweet feelings behind a brave and smiling face. Today, I look out my window to see an empty nest above my front porch. A month or so ago, I had watched the mother's birds build a nest. She diligently sat on her eggs through the cold rain and winds of early spring. Just last week, I saw 3 baby birds chirping there, waiting to be fed. Now the nest stood empty. When did they leave? Where did the time go? How quickly they flew away. I realized that as my daughter is preparing to leave home, we have some similar feelings. Like my daughter, I feel as if I too am flying right now on wings that are a bit shaky and uncertain. Yet as I look to God, I am reassured that neither of us faces the unknown alone. In Isaiah, we are reminded that God has carried us from birth and will continue to carry and sustain us even into old age. In knowing this promise, I find I am ready that my daughter or son go after all. The prayer, we now bow our heads and give these blessings to the senior, carrying on and forward the big steps of life, and then help carry the 8th grade into high school and our 1st graders. Let's borrow his prayer. Dear God, thank you for your promise never to leave us. Because you hold us close, give us the courage to let go when we need to. In Jesus' name, pray. Amen. Everyone will please stand, and our 8th graders will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Ichi ho the navia, takia, nali nami taya, sabira, na americum. Ichi ho the lulu, ala shabana, kibina verba, ata, hiro, ina kwaka, na tanga. Elakana, nisho, kato, kako, uli, ala shabaka, tibui, chi. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Graduates, school board chairperson Edwardson, superintendent Callen, teachers, family, friends, welcome tonight to the graduation of the class of 2015. This wouldn't be possible without everyone in this room and their contribution. We thank you for that and for your efforts in helping them reach this milestone in their life and to begin the journey that they have in front of them. You know, we really live in a great place. As we look out at these mountains, we kind of feel sorry for the rest of the people who live on the North Slope. And we really are lucky to be in this great place that we are a part of. We're also very lucky to be a part of the school district that we are a part of. They've been very supportive and have helped guide these students to where they are today. Just recently, last year of course, we had a dream to have an alternative school in this school. And we presented that to the board and to the school district. And they really like the idea. And many of the individuals on this stage tonight are here because they were willing to support us in that. So we appreciate them and the part that they've played in that. We're really lucky here. It's one of the few schools that has turnover, and all of the teachers will be back next year, most of them. My wife, I'm taking her with me. But we're really lucky. They love it here, it's their home, and they do a great job with their children. And I know that they care about them, because I hear it every week. So they also have made a huge difference in graduates' lives. Of course, none of this could happen without the family and support that happens in the home. And so we appreciate that and are grateful for you, the job that you do, and for all that you do to make their lives better. At this time, we will go ahead with the commencement exercises and wish the best for these 2015 graduates.
Our first kids in the corner to be promoted are our kindergarten students who are going on to first grade. I think they must be pretty eager. Good evening again to everyone. Good to be back. This looks familiar. I've had the privilege, this is 2 years running now, to send our amazing little soldiers to first grade, and tonight is no exception. The school year has absolutely flown by, and yet your children have grown so very much. Oh my goodness, since they've become part of our little warm and fuzzy classroom family. We've done so many things together. We've played together. We've laughed and learned together. We've complained and blamed each other. Done a lot of that. Together, just like real families do. But through it all, they have matured so much. Ever since I had them first walk into my classroom, I thought, these are nothing more than babies. And I approached Mrs. Kippert and I said, who's been loving on these kids? And she put her head down and she said, I have. I said, well, they're in kindergarten now. Well, very soon they won't be in kindergarten anymore, will they? Before I call them up, I would like to thank each and every one of my parents, each and every one of my grandparents, my aunts, my uncles, any siblings that listened to the read at home for the 10th or 20th time and did it with mostly a smile. Thank you so very much for all of your support. You supported them, but you've also supported me as their teacher, and I truly appreciate that. So now, without further ado, I would like to call some names. I'm first going to call Anna Nakapia. Come on up, Anna. Kindergartners are going to remain right on the stage where they are. Introduce you to the 2015-2016 class of first grade. Our next group up will be our eighth graders that are being promoted to high school. Task that we are allowed to do as school board members, this is the best one. Being here for graduations and watching all these young people and their proud families, this is the best moment for a school board member. I'm going to take this off of the podium because I think I need to talk to the graduates and I don't like to have my back to them, so maybe I'll step over this way so I can also see them. Just to start with, I would ask that everybody who is related to these students or who has taught these students or worked with these students in the school to stand up. Thank you. You guys see that? It's the whole audience. You know, it says, you can sit down, thank you. It says in the Bible in Romans 13 that each of us is given talents and that we are to use those talents to benefit the whole, much like the different parts of the body all work together. You're all one body here. Each of you is part of it. You see that? And I guess the one thing I just want to say to you tonight, as you move into adulthood, and to you eighth graders as you move into school, and even to the kindergartners as you move into high school, and even to the kindergartners as they move into first grade, what I would say to you is look for the talent. Look for the talents that God's given you, your God-given talent. and find out how you can use that. And your talent is something you're going to feel passionate about. So look for your passion. I just want to tell you a really, really short story about a young man who found his passion and made a difference. As a matter of fact, the school that we're standing in is partly due to the work that this young man did. Some of you are related to him. Just to tell you just a couple of stories from his life. When he was very, very young, this was in that he was born in 1943. That was a long time ago. They had dog teams still. And people there in Barrow had reindeer herds. And when he was very, very young, he was attacked by dogs. He ended up with 250 stitches. And he came out of it and he had a stutter. And the lesson here is that sometimes hard things happen to us in life, but we don't have to let them stop us. And you may have already had hard things, and you will, I promise, have more hard things in your future. But you don't let them stop you. This young man had a stutter all of his life, but he didn't let that stop him. When he was 9 years old, he saw something bad happen to the reindeer herders. The reindeer herd, the Navy was doing seismic work out in Petroleum Reserve 4 east of Barrow, and they lost their reindeer herds. And this he was only 9 years old, and he saw that they went to court. They went to the federal government, and they asked for the federal government to try and give them some restitution to pay them for the fact that their work had caused them to lose the reindeer herds, and they lost. The federal government said no. And this young man, at 9 years old, he said to himself, one day he was going to get smart enough so that he could kick those kind of people off of his land if they were going to treat them that way. And you know what he did? When he was about 23 years old, he filed the claim of ownership for the entire North Slope. He said it was owned by the Nunamiut people. And he pushed it. And the result was the land claim that gave us all of the corporations that you see, ASRC, that you get the big dividend from. And the next thing that he did with another group of leaders is he pushed for the formation of the North Slope Borough, which is a municipal government, which collects its revenues from oil development, and that's what paid for this school that we're in here today. So this is a young kid, and he stuttered all his life. When he would get up to speak publicly, sometimes he had to holler because it's the only way he could get the words to come out without stuttering, but he didn't let that stop him. Anybody know who I'm talking about? Edub Edwardson, my husband's cousin. He passed away last week out at Whale Camp, and we're having his service this Saturday. And I just wanted to share his story with you because there's something in there for you guys to think about as you move into the future. Look for what your passion is, and don't let anything stop you. Don't expect it's always going to be perfect. It won't be. But if you don't give up, you will win. And I wish you the best, and we are all really proud of you. Thank you. Our next speaker is our superintendent, Dr. Peggy Callan. Good enough, though. I'm going to pretend to follow Debbie's lead. 8th graders, 12th graders, graduates, Harvard, BC, and Kananaskwa. I am I want to thank you for inviting me to the graduation and inviting me to speak. And I'm humbled to be here while surrounded, as Debbie pointed out, by your families, by the staff, by the community, those who contributed to all of your success, helped the 8th graders get here, and helped us graduates get there. So I am pleased to represent the school district, but again, humbled because these are the people that have made a difference in your lives. I looked up and looked and figured to see what I talked about when I was here last time. And last time I was here, I talked about the three R's. And when and your Akas and Appas and I went to school, there were three R's, and they were called reading, writing, and arithmetic, which isn't even good language, but anyways, that's what they were called. But when I was here before, I talked about the new three R's, and they are respect, responsibility, and resilience. And I actually have a different message tonight, but when I was listening to Debbie's talk, and when I was thinking about graduation, I'm going to come back to that third 3R, which was resilience. Arnold Brower Jr. and I were traveling to a graduation, and while we were talking over lunch, he turned to me and he said, he was a school board member at the time, and he said, "The Inupiats are resilient people." You know what resilience means? You know what resilience means? I looked it up. This is what the dictionary says. It says, resilience is to be able to recover from difficult situations. So the Inupiat are resilient people. And that really stuck with me, and that totally ties to what Debbie just said. Itak was a resilient person. He got hurt by a dog team, he got well, he stuttered, he still got up and made speeches. He continued to advocate for his people. If you're a resilient person, adults out there, raise your hand if any of you have ever had anything not go your way. Well, we have some honest adults. Let's try the students. Students, eighth graders, students here, have you ever not had things go your way? Raise your hand. All right. If you persevered and continued and came back and didn't give up, you were a resilient person. And all of you seniors, I have a feeling that something, somewhere in your high school career did not go perfectly and you became a resilient person. So, graduates. Being a resilient person got you here, eighth graders. You need to continue to be resilient. You've got to walk across the stage in 4 years. But graduates don't give up on being a resilient person as you move forward. The other thing I wanted to just mention to you, I learned that you were going to do the flower ceremony, and that's not done at all the communities. It's done at some of the communities. It's one of my favorite things. But when I was thinking about it, I have a message to go with the flower ceremony, and it's the power of gratitude. It's really important to be grateful. Your parents, your akkas, your appas probably told you to say please and thank you as you were growing up. And it's not only important to do it because it's polite and it's a good thing, but it's good for you. People who say thank you and are grateful have more meaningful lives. Eighth graders, they get better grades. People who are gratitude get better grades. They contribute more to their communities. They have a better life. How do you say thank you in Inupiat? Okay, ready? Loud and clear, all of you guys. One, two, three. Right. Thank you. I am not fuck to you. So, think about what you're grateful for. I'm grateful that I live in Barrow and there's still snow on the ground because I like to go cross-country skiing. I'm grateful for the snowbirds because I love them. I'm grateful that I work for the North Slope Borough School District because it's a wonderful place to work. Think about what you're grateful for. Do you want to tell me anything? I had a feeling that wouldn't go. Sometimes they do, but when you're handing out your rose tonight, make sure you say "Kind Enough Puck" as you hand out your rose after Brooke's talk. So, Timothy, Jason, Riley, Ashley, Dalen, Miranda, Molly, Nellie, when you hand out your rose tonight after Mr. Fry's speech, say "Kind Enough Puck" and say thank you. And again, from me, Kaya Nakpak, to all of the community, thank you for making these students successful. But students, you did the work. You did it. You were successful. You should be proud of yourselves. You are walking around across the stage tonight. Move forward. Claim your destiny. And I will end with Dr. Seuss for both the kindergartners, the eighth graders, and the graduates. This is what Dr. Seuss said about it. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the guy who will decide where to go. So make good decisions about where to go. Sign up, Buck. And now for our commencement or keynote address. This is somebody the students chose to have as their speaker tonight, Mr. Brooksby.
I need something to hold on to, so I'm not going to move over there, I might fall off. And I am the keynote address, so it's my responsibility to talk to the graduates, which I've been doing for quite a while now, and I watched a few keynote addresses online to get a few good ideas. My favorite was by Jim Carrey. I think he spoke it here at a college. Anyway, you should watch it. And so, really appreciate, you know, what's gone on here tonight, and what's happened, and the things that have been said, and so hopefully some of the stuff that I can say, for a few words that will kind of add to that. This is a very exciting event, and first I'd like to wish a very sincere congratulations to the kindergartners and the eighth graders, and especially to the eight amazing graduates sitting here on the stage tonight. It's a well-deserved special occasion for all of them. And it's a unique group. Not only do we have larger groups in a while to reach the impressive milestone of high school graduates, but we also have a nice mix of stories and pathways represented. Some of the graduates here tonight took the traditional classroom high school route. Several utilized boarding schools for at least a portion of their education, and we also have some who went by way of alternative high school programs to get their diploma. Not to mention of those who are taking care of a bit of unfinished business here tonight with this ceremony. We even have other members of the graduating class of 2015 that are from Anaktuvuk Pass who are not in this gym tonight but are instead wearing different school colors on their graduation night this week as they received their diplomas at places they decided to try out and then stayed there. One interesting thing, though, that all of these students have in common is that not any one of them completed their high school education within the walls of a single school. Every single one of them sitting up here experienced, even if only briefly, the emotions that come with extending themselves into the uncomfortable unknown, trying new things. That's not always easy. So they're a good example to each of us of success through perseverance, and that no two life paths are ever the same. Before I say more on these two interesting ideas, I'd like to mention that I myself can relate in a very personal way to this style of education. Most of these kids have heard me tell it before, but my pathway through college to become the teacher that I am today went by way of six different colleges and spanned the course of a decade, full 10 years. My most common title as I traveled many interesting and sometimes difficult roads was the uncommon, non-traditional student. In pursuing my ambitions, I too was required to muster deep perseverance and accept that there were times that I needed to walk alone as my path was my own and seldom identical to another's. Perseverance is defined as steadfastness in doing something despite difficulty or delay in achieving success. And for you graduates, I'd like to point out that if you've learned nothing else during your years of schooling, you did learn how to persevere. That is to keep doing something even when it's hard, even when it sucks. And your teacher sucks, and the whole world sucks. And even some of your friends suck because they liked the subject and the assignment was easy for them. The good news is that you now know that you can do hard things if you just keep trying. Success is not about whether or not you're smart enough, because you are. Success is about how hard you're willing to try and for how long. Today, I truly hope that you are feeling the joy that comes along with your success, as a diploma is a well-deserved prize that is not an item, maybe purchased in a store. Think about that. Even in the biggest and best of cities where you can get anything you like, there's no such thing as a high school diploma store. This is something that must be earned, and that's because we believe that there are important and essential life lessons to be learned by earning. One of those being perseverance, which has already been mentioned, another is hard work, another is patience, and I'm sure we could easily rattle off several more without even mentioning the ability to read, write, and do math, which are also skills that are that you are graduating with. As you know, I'm a physical and health education teacher by training and trade, and so the skills of successful living are central to the lessons that I present. Any student who has ever attended one of my PE classes knows that are more important to me than winning the game is how we treat our teammates, how we treat our opponents, and how we treat the refs. This skill is called showing respect and extending kindness. Additionally, there are a few things that you have learned while in school that I would like to point out to you that will serve you well when you use them and have been keys to the success of many important people. The first of these is the importance of attitude. I want you to think about the difference between your good days and your bad days that you have had while going to school. It's true that there are events and circumstances that cause rises and falls in our feelings, but isn't it also true that there have been times that you were able to overcome setbacks simply by deciding to be happy, even if it took you a while to make that choice? And isn't it also true that when our attitude is set, there's usually not much anybody can do about it? We don't want them to. Many times, the difference between a good day and a bad one is the attitude that we pick for ourselves. A perfect example is math problems. Math problems themselves don't change at all, and they don't have feelings. Algebra 1 is still Algebra 1 and will likely be the same Algebra 1 for many years to come. Unlike words, numbers have no feelings associated with them, and neither do multiplication and division problems that you had to do in your various classes. And yet, think about your time spent doing math problems. How easy or how hard and how much time you had to spend was largely impacted by your attitude that day. Not a math teacher. But I do go to homework club, and I know that mad students can't solve math problems. On the other hand, when someone is in a good mood, it is incredible how productive they can be even when the problems are challenging. I'd like to suggest to you that along with perseverance, if you mix in a healthy dose of positive attitude, your success rate for whatever you decide to do will go up. Strong-minded, happy people are unstoppable, and at this point in your lives, you guys are capable of absolutely anything you set your mind to. That brings me to my next key for success, desire. I mentioned this before, but I'd like you to take a minute real quick and look down the row at the other graduates, and also remember Orma and Janeray for a bit right now. As you think about and look at each other, try to remember all the cool places each other have been and the neat things that everyone has done. Remember, not a single one of you spent all your high school years in one building, and many of you have at least some boarding school experience. Not only does this demonstrate that there are many pathways to success, but more importantly, this tells me that at some point in your young life, the desire for something better than what you already had was so strong in you that you were willing to change a major part of your life to go and get it. That is called desire. Desire is a strong feeling of wanting to have something or for something to happen. As described in the words of the song, desire is that fire you light that even pouring thunderclouds can't put up. All pathways to success are different, but a necessary ingredient for making good things happen in your life, such as high school graduation, is desire. And clearly, you have it. You have wanted it bad enough to make it happen, and you saw it through to the end. Even if you had to lean on someone else's desire for a time, getting nudged along the way by caring people in your life, but in the end, they could not earn it for you. And so I know, and you know, that you have enough desire within you to make good things happen in your life. Through perseverance and desire, you are able to earn a high school diploma, and you are capable of anything. And I truly believe that. So as you travel down your path in life, you'll need those skills in the changing world that we live in. Just like your ancestors relied on them for their success and survival, you will need them for yours as well. And we hope desperately that you won't stop there. Me, the teachers, your parents and other family members, we know that you are what you are capable of, and we want you to become awesome. You can use the skills that you have learned and developed to make your own success and become this generation's Simon Peniak, for whom the museum is named, or Robert Bob Hoggook, whose name is on the front of the clinic. All teachers on the North Slope know the stories of Evan Hobson of Barrow, Harold Cavill of Kotoic, and Howard Rock from Point Hope, and the great things they did. But what stories of perseverance and desire will be told about you? What buildings will have your name on the front? What awesome attitudes will your grandchildren admire of you? You have proved to me and yourselves that you can do anything. But your high school diploma always reminds you of that. Whether you choose work, training, trade school, or college, don't forget that you have already proved to yourself that you can do whatever you set out for. Some of you are probably thinking that, sure, Mr. Fry, that all sounds nice, but what about when real life hits and everything sucks again? And you're right, life can be hard, and at times we all do fail. But remember, you learn how to do that at school too. Failing is part of it all. Failing is simply life teaching us how to play the game better. One team always has to lose when there's a basketball game, and that does not mean the game is not worth playing. And just like you have always done before, you will high-five the other team, spend another hard week in practice, then give it another go the next chance you get. Success and winning are not about never losing or never failing. They're about learning from your losses and becoming better by them. I've seen many of you do that in sports as your coach and in school as your teacher. Failure will make you stronger and smarter if you recognize it as an opportunity and take advantage of it. Yes, failure is an opportunity. In fact, if I were Avicii, I might say, when face to face with all our fears, we learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. I've been through a lot of those experiences with you and share many of your memories. In fact, it has been a privilege and a joy for me to be a part of your lives, and that goes for all my other students as well, both former and current. I want you to know that I believe in you, and I've seen you be awesome. And today, I leave high school behind. I hope that you can look back on it and enjoy your success and learn from your failure. A few last lyrics. One day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. This is out of order, but please don't let it slip away. As you go forward from here, I would encourage you to do the things that you have learned make you successful. You have the skills. I'm excited to see what you do next in your lives. Please know that I'm proud of you today. Thank you for being who you are, for the things you have taught me, because as you're about to find out, learning does not end after graduation. The world spins way too fast for that. But with perseverance, desire, and a good attitude, anything is possible. Thank you.
Next up is the ceremony of roses where students can give out the people in their lives that have made this day happen. Smile.
like that. You steal away the rain and just like that. You make me smile like that.
Next up is our Valid Victorian address. Riley Manning has kept a 4.0 all 4 years of her high school. So our Valid Victorian this year is Riley Manning.
As I've been thinking about graduation the whole year, the hardest thing for me has been trying to figure out how to fit all of my hair under this hat. Like, even today, I was still stressing about it. I'm glad it kind of worked out. I still might look a little crazy, but the best I can do, so bear with me. As pretty much everyone gave my talk already, life is kind of hard sometimes, and the important thing is how we deal with it. So I'm going to share a story. It's a little embarrassing, so I hope the people in the story don't mind. Last April, Ifley and Abby and I decided to go snowboarding. It was one of my first times snowboarding, and Mr. Fry was like, yeah, you can use a snow machine. So I was like, sweet, this is going to be so fun. Well, turns out we're not that good of drivers. And when we're up Sisahawkvik, we tipped. And Ifley was the only smart one. She leaned the other way, and me and Abby tried to stop it, but it was too late. The snow machine tipped, and I was like, my first thought, oh my gosh, we're all going to die. This is so terrible. I'm going to be in so much trouble. Their parents are going to kill me. Mr. Fry's never going to talk to me again. I ruined his snow machine. So I was freaking out. The snow was like up to our hips. I look over, and Abby and Ifley are just laughing their heads off at me freaking out. It was so stressful. So obviously they had a better attitude about it than I did. So we're like, okay, we can push this out. Listen, baby, we're strong. We got this. So we started pushing. 2 minutes later, nothing. And then Ifley gets a text and someone's like, are you guys up on Sisahawkvik? I was like, oh my gosh, someone already saw us. We're already in trouble. So a little exasperated, really tired from trying to push. I was like, okay, guys, I think we need to pray. We're this desperate. We need to pray. And so we prayed and got the snow machine up, and everything was good and great. And so just from that situation, I think it's important to, it's okay to freak out a little bit when bad things happen, but you have to remember to laugh at yourself. And if you need to ask for help, it's okay to ask for help. And so I just want to say that to all of everyone in school, I guess, and all the old people too. It's okay to mess up sometimes, as long as you do your best to fix it. And I don't know, I just want to say thank you for the past 2 years in this community. I felt so welcome, and it was going to be hard to leave, and it's so beautiful here, and I've learned so much from all of you. I'm so grateful for the opportunity I've had to talk to you today. Thank you.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming to this evening. We all know that high school is the first step of succeeding in life to get to the point where you want to be. And the first step is graduating from high school. Okay. I remember the first time I entered high school. It's like you entered a new stage in life, how to succeed in life and in school. It's really important that you... It's really important that you 8th graders come and support your school, because 8th graders are the next generation. For the past 4 years, I had a really fun, horrible, exciting, emotional time of my life. To let you 8th graders know, all the 4 years of high school will go by fast, so each and one of you better enjoy the time in school, because you're going to be up here on the stage in no time. I'm telling you, it will go by really fast. Okay. I remember when I was in 8th grade, I had the best time of my childhood memories. That's when Hugh Stenson was our 8th grade teacher. Hugh was one of the best teachers ever. Every day I was excited to go to school and learn. 1 year, Hugh taught Garrett and I how to make an Eskimo drum. I was so excited to go to school just to go make my drum for my father. That's the drum I gave him for my 8th grade promotion. So these are the people I would like to thank. I would like to thank Ludi, E3, Tun, Hugo, Tyrell, Darren, Chase, and Justice for making my last basketball season memorable when we went to state. That's something that I will always remember. And these are some of the teachers that I would like to thank. There's Ms. Snyder, Sally Navarre, Ms. Grell, Ingalisa, yeah, Hust, Mr. Root, Mr. Lee, and Ms. Fry, and Ms. Bowman, and Rachel Ryder for making my preschool and high school best days of my life. I was really thanking you guys for the support that you guys gave me. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you guys. Thank you. I would also thank my family for the support they gave me throughout the school years. Thank you, Anna, Mom, Baba, Elizabeth, Ilay, Scott, and Abba. Thanks for being there and the support that you guys gave me. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Next up, Molly Penn.
Congratulations, fellow classmates of 2015.
You did. Thank you to my mom for coming for me throughout my years. Thank you. My dad, for your endless support. Love you, Dad. Love you, Mom. Gracias. God love us for always being there to support me through my trials. Your encouragement helped me to help me to where I am now. Thank you for my honor, honey, and advocating for all your love and support. Last but not least, my best friend, Barry, my girl, Angelique. To my bros, for all the love and support to finish, you all are the best. To my teachers and principal, all I can say is thank you for putting up with me. Thank you to Mr. Snyder and everyone else. Those I didn't mention, those who are. It is an honor to graduate from high school. I have dreamt of this moment since I was a little girl, walk down the aisle and represent the color blue and yellow. Now is the time to go out into the world and discover my dreams, see what the world has to offer. Overcome things I never thought I would, and through my ups and downs, I've learned that anything is possible if we work for it. Life is like an open book. It's up to us to tell how our story begins and how it ends. As they say, sky is the limit.
Next up, Nelly Rulon. Good evening. I'd like to thank everyone for coming tonight for our graduation and the eighth grader's promotion and the kindergartners going into best grade. To the eighth graders, you're going to have a stressful 4 years, but yet it's worth it in the end, even though you get mad, frustrated, not wanting to do work. I've been there. My 11th grade year, I heard we went to school. I didn't go to school almost my whole second semester because of the loss of a loved one. And I have this year, I went to Nunano, did my half a year there, and I finished up at CETA. And I'm thankful for Mr. Manning, wherever you are, for letting me walk with my classmates here. If it wasn't for him, I'd still be in Bear today, walking tomorrow, but I'm happy I'm home with family, friends, and my best friend Ashley, of course. Now where do I begin? I'll be heading to UAF or ACC in fall, and I will be doing fire science and coming home to work. And if it wasn't for people here, I wouldn't have made it to today. Thank you. Miranda Moore.
Come on, girl.
I like all of them. I'm thinking of my family and friends, the staff for pushing me through. The alternative program, it was a self-paced program, but it was for courses. We had to pay, like, every credit we needed to catch up. He did it, or I did it, with Natasha's help, and I canceled it. And when they did the career expo in Barrow, I remember what the superintendent said, be prepared for where you're headed, and that's always been on my mind.
but then the whole life thing that pushed me to. And my grandma and Dada, they would wake me up every morning. My Dada would yell, "Miranda, you awake? Miranda, it's almost 6:30. But yeah, I'm happy getting my diploma. But I'm now shy and kind of hard with it. And thank you all for coming.
Our students were recommended for many scholarships this year, and many of them are planning post-secondary college educations or trainings. So the Arctic Education Foundation awarded Timothy Huff Jr. an amount of $2,000 to be used for vocational training for higher education and recognition of leadership qualities throughout the academic achievements during his high school years. The Justice Mickey Honor Leadership Award. The Arctic Education Foundation Harry Huger Leadership Award. This scholarship is awarded to Miranda Mori, the amount of $1,000 to be used for vocational training for higher education in recognition of leadership qualities through her academic achievements during her high school years. The Arctic Education Foundation Rachel Riley Leadership Award. This scholarship is awarded to Ashley Michiana in the amount of $1,000 to be used for vocational training for higher education and recognition of leadership qualities through academic achievements during her high school years. The University of Alaska Scholars Award, Certificate of Recognition. On behalf of the Board of Regents, the University of Alaska proudly presents Riley Manning with the UA Scholars Award for exceptional academic achievement. The University of Alaska Scholars Award is bestowed upon the 10% of Alaska's high school graduating class of 2015. This award is redeemable for educational expenses at any University of Alaska campus under the terms and conditions spelled out in the UA Scholars Program. Congratulations, I am pleased to notify that you have been selected as a recipient of the Hillcorp Future Leaders of America Scholarship, awarded in the amount of $10,000, $2,500 per semester, renewable for up to 3 consecutive years. You should be very proud of your accomplishments for winning this scholarship. I wish you great success at Brigham Young University, Idaho, majoring in general studies. I know you will be a great ambassador for Hillcorp and serve as a role model for others. Congratulations, Riley Manning. Yay. Okay, it is my honor to present the North Slope Rural Mayor's Office Scholarship. The scholarship goes out to the top students with the highest GPA. This comes with a letter from Mayor Charlotte Brower. She says, congratulations on your education. This is a significant milestone. You now have a chance to truly shape your life. I want to encourage you to chase your dreams, and I hope that the North Slope Rural can be a part of that future. This is a $1,000 scholarship that goes out to these students. Ashley Macchiano. Miranda Mori. Timothy Agu. Mary Lynn. Congratulations to you, students. I'm sorry I forgot one that the certificate did not arrive in time, but the Alaska school counselors took recommendations from school counselors around Alaska, and Timothy Agook won a full scholarship to Aptech to plumbing and heating program that he wants to go to, and he was the only student from the North Slope that was picked for this honor. Principal Pat Manning and our board president, Debbie Edwardson, for the completion to our seniors. We're also asking for any staff members who want to greet the graduates that you come to this part of the stage over here at the bottom of the stairs.
Before we do this part, there was something left off the program, and that is the slideshow, and we will be doing that at the end. So we won't be having the drumming and dancing tonight. We will do the slideshow for the seniors at the end of the conference. School Board President Debbie Edwardson, member of the Board of North Slope Rural School District, teachers, parents, families, and friends. As principal, I certify that these students have successfully satisfied the standards set by the state of Alaska, as well as the North Slope Rural School District of Education, and may participate in these graduation exercises. It is my honor to represent the faculty and staff of Nunamiut School and recommend these seniors sitting before you for receipt of their high school diploma.
Thank you, Principal Manning. As a member of the North Slope Rural School District Board of Education, and by the powers vested in the board by the state of Alaska, and as a member, as a member of a board of education of a home rural borough, I accept your certification and the recommendation of these students. Having completed all the requirements of graduation set forth by the policy of the North Slope Rural School District and the state of Alaska, I declare these students graduates of Nunavut School and of the North Slope Rural School District. Congratulations, students, we're proud of you.
Amanda Alice Onavigara Mori. Molly Betty Katak Penn. Dylan Reed Payap Mori. Jason Patrick Ulimau Gordon. Riley Nicole Amalok Manning. Ashley Rose Nasu Mikana. Timothy Yuzala Aruk Jr. Belly Rochelle Seku Ruin.
Hey, seniors, if you'll take a seat in the audience right there in front, and we'll do the slideshow. I'm sorry. You get to turn your tassels. You are now graduated. You're official. Go ahead and do it. Seniors, right after this, you'll come back up on the stage and do your thing, and so we'll have a slide presentation now. Molly, I think we may have to use me that way just a little bit to get the card in. Ralph, when we're ready, could you... Thank you.
Thank you. God knows. make the difference that I can make. Our differences, they do a lot to teach us how to use the tools and kids we got here. We got a lot at stake. And in the end, it's to my friend, at least we did intend for us to work. We didn't break, we didn't burn. We had to learn how to live without the world caving in. I had to learn what I got and what I'm not and who I am. I won't give up, oh, up. Even if the skies get rough, I'm giving you all my love. Still looking up, still looking up, but I won't give up.
Presenting the graduating class of 2015.
Thank you. Thank you. up. Did you get your piece of cake? Yes.
I got caught up in line and talked to someone.
Out of my way, elders. Oh.
Thank you. Touch the ground.